and biomedical field. One of the academicians has quoted, "The academic success depends upon the number of publications, but nowadays the process of selecting the right journal has become increasingly complex. Because of proliferation of journals, areas of specialization, and emergence of interdisciplinary topics. So that to clear all such type of doubts, such type of ambiguities, today we are having with us an eminent speaker, Dr. Ajay Simante sir, University Swayam Coordinator, Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, HNB Garhwal University. Actually, this is a very brief introduction of his. We'll see in very short time period his strong and inspirational profile. Now, I would like to request respected Principal Dr. R.G. Kate Deshmukh sir to give a welcome address. Please.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
A very good morning, one and all. Good morning and hearty welcome, Dr. Ajay Simante, sir. It gives me an immense pleasure to welcome you all for today's webinar entitled Journal Targeting and in Pharmaceuticals and Biomedical Field by Dr. Ajay Simante, sir. We always are in a process of publishing our research work every now and then. Submitting a manuscript to an unsuitable journal is a common mistake many of us are making usually. So choosing a proper journal is very important to publish our work. There are so many journals available in many varieties. So targeting a right journal to enhance the chances of publication to reach the target audience becomes needful. Some of the factors in a selection of right journal we generally consider are the topics which a journal publishes, particular journal publishes, then the types of articles, for example, if it is a review article or it is a research article, then the target audience, so who are interested in referring your work, and the length of manuscript and time to be taken for the publication, because this time is also very important. If you are going to submit your thesis or PhD or your research work, then this time of publication is also very important. And last but not the least, the reputation of the journal, that is a very important factor to be considered. That is its impact factor, then its readership, and the prestige of the authors who are publishing in that particular journal. So these and many more, all our queries and dilemmas will be addressed by today's eminent speaker, Dr. Ajay Simante sir. So instead of taking much of your time, I wish you all a very informative and helpful session ahead. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to request Professor Ashish Phuge, sir, to please introduce our speaker.
Phuge sir, you are not audible. Yes. Sir, your voice is not coming properly.
Okay, sir.
Phuge sir, your voice is not coming.
Hello.
Yes.
Good morning to all. I am Mr. Ashish Phuge, Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry, RJSPMS College of Pharmacy. Welcome you all for today's webinar on the topic journal targeting in the pharmaceutical and biomedical field. Today's eminent speaker is Dr. Ajay Simalki, who is the University Swayam Coordinator and Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, HNB Gadwal University, Gadwal, Uttarakhand. He is having total 18 years of experience in the field of pharmacy. He did his M.Pharm in pharmaceutics, MBA in operations management, PhD in chemistry and pharmacy, and postdoc at Meijo University, Japan. He has awarded with the Daiko Foundation postdoctoral research fellowship and invited by Meijo University, Japan as a visiting scientist for research. He has received the prestigious research award in the pharmacy by UGC New Delhi for the year 2016-18, which is a national award given in every 2 years to the 100 teachers for excellence in research from all over the India, covering all the subjects. He has also awarded with the Young Scientist Award 2007 by the Uttarakhand Council of Science and Technology. He is a member of the Asian Council of Science Editors. Also, he is the expert reviewer of Iceland Research Foundation Iceland, Israel Science Foundation Israel, Scientific Expert for Ministry of Institution and University Research Italy, and DST Government of India. He is the peer reviewer of Elsewhere Books, editorial board member and reviewer for various national and international journals of repute. He has served as the founder vice president of Association of Pharmaceutical Teachers of India of Uttarakhand State Branch from the year 2008-13. He has delivered more than 60 lectures on the various topics like open educational resources, academic writing, nanoparticle research, research methodology, research ethics, software in research, blended or flipped learning, research proposal writing, academic integrity, plagiarism, and pharmaceutical research. He has received more than 1.5 crores for his research projects from various funding agencies like DST, AICT, UGC, and DAE. He has published 74 research papers in the various national and international journals. He has the 2 patents to his credits. He has also contributed to the development of e-content and e-modules for annual refresher program in teaching course. Is one of the most cited researchers with the H-Index 24. Total citations are greater than 1800 and total impact is greater than 90. I know you are eagerly waiting for the today's session. Sir will be delivering a webinar on journal targeting in the pharmaceutical and biomedical field. I welcome Dr. Ajay Simalki on the behalf of principal, vice principal, and all faculty members of RJSPMS College of Pharmacy. Thank you. Over to you, Pakeshwar Madam.
Thank you so much, sir, for a great introduction. Before proceeding towards the session, there is one announcement for the participants. Those who are having any queries regarding session, please you can put it into a chat box and we'll definitely discuss it in question-answer session. The feedback form link will be displayed at the end of the session and there will be the quiz in the feedback form. Those participants who will get the 50% score in this quiz will receive an e-certificate. So now I would like to request our eminent speaker, Dr. Ajay Simalti, sir, to please proceed to the session. Thank you.
Thank you. Vandaniya Maa Sharade. Maa Sharada ko naman karte hue sabse pehle. First of all, I would like to thank the entire team of RJSPM College of Pharmacy for conducting the webinar on a very hot topic. Thanks a lot, Principal Sir. Dr. Ashish, Bhagyasri, and the entire team, Sneha, for choosing this particular topic, which is highly demanded in this era, in which every academician and researcher is expected to deliver and present his research work at the national as well as the international level. And this is possible only with the help of research publications. without going much in detail of the background, I will directly going to my presentation. I had divided my presentation. I'll be starting at this 11:11 by my watch. So first 15 minutes, I'll be discussing what are the things which are required. First 10 minutes, I'll wrap up rapidly that what are the things in all you must learn about the academic writing, because it's a very vast topic. And whatever I could learn, I have a great desire, I have a great passion to share, because it is possible. It is possible that I may not have the resources to convert my research work into publications or do that kind of research which can be published in good impact. Ho sakta hai aapke college ke paas jyada resources ho. It might be possible my college is or my department is having much resources. So at least the person who are having the capability to convert the research into research publications. What is happening in the scenario that very good research are being done in some colleges and some institutions, but they get unnoticed. They don't get any attention because they lack the skills required for academic writing. And that's why we have come up with the concept of sharing our academic writing knowledge, whatever we know. So at least if I'm unable to do a quality research which can be published in research publication, whatever you are having in your resources, you can get it published. You can get good research work done and then get it published. Kar sakte hain aap. But you need the skills to present that research work. You know, doing an experiment, doing a research is the entirely different domain than publishing that research into the publications. So let me share my screen with you, my presentation I'm going to share with you. So friends, welcome. I think you can see my screen now. Yes. So welcome in this webinar on general targeting in pharmaceutical and biomedical fields. So we'll be discussing the specific aspect of general targeting apart from the first aspect, in which I'll be discussing the what things you must learn for getting your work published. And then we will be moving to the journal targeting aspect in particular. So friends, so very warm welcome from HNB Gadwal University. It is a university, it's a central university located in the bank of Alaknanda River, and in the place in the holy place of Lord's Dev Bhumi Uttarakhand. So I welcome all, you all. You have done the research work. You want to publish. Do you know the timing you should follow? Do not wait till the completion of the research. It is the first mistake most of us commit. Plan earlier. So don't wait. Don't wait till the end. Plan it at a suitable time, at earlier time. Otherwise, you won't be able to conduct, to click that work in a timely manner. And time is utmost important. If you are getting the paper published after you have done the work 10 years before, you have done the work and you are going for publication, there's no meaning. The contextual importance is, or the contemporary importance is gone. So, in this tone, I would like to let you know that what are the things you must learn in academic writing. Okay, academic writing, the things to know. I have compiled a few things and then we'll be jumping on the journal targeting. The first thing is, learn the academic English. Why I have mentioned academic English? Because English may be a native language for us, but just believe me that academic English, for academic English, even the people sitting in Western world are also non-natives. उनके लिए भी वो मातृभाषा नहीं है. एकेडमिक इंग्लिश किसी की मदर टंग नहीं है. इसलिए दिमाग में जो हवा है ना हमारे, सबसे पहले वो निकाल देना है कि मेरा इंग्लिश कमजोर है या मैं इंग्लिश नहीं लिख पा रहा हूँ. यू नो, राइटिंग फॉर एकेडमिक इंग्लिश, ऑब्वियसली यू नीड द ग्रामर एंड द थिंग्स, बेसिक थिंग्स, बट इंग्लिश इन एकेडमिक राइटिंग मस्ट बी इफेक्टिव वन. इट शुड बी सिंपल वन. देयर इज नो, यू नीड नॉट टू बी अ शेक्सपियर, यू नीड नॉट टू बी अ विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ for writing the paper. You just write the simple words with clear-cut meaning. Clarity is at most important. Clarity is at most important. It must be concise. Whatever you are writing must be in concise manner, reader-friendly, because we are writing for our readers. So it must be reader-friendly. Don't put the complex things, complex word, don't write in complexity. It obviously, it must be free of errors. The voices, whatever you are writing, active voice, passive voice, don't be fascinated in writing in passive voice always. It must be a good balance of active and passive voice. Then styles, APA, MLA, CMS, though they I don't give much preference of learning these styles until they are recommended by a particular institute for writing the thesis. Otherwise, styles आपको वही follow करना है जो आपका journal कहता है. Okay, whatever the journal is asking for writing that particular, adopting that particular style is should be your preference. So ज्यादा bother मत कीजिए कि APA में लिखना है कि MLA में लिखना है, CMA जो बोलता है, जो institute बोलता है thesis लिखने के लिए, जो format बोलता है, या और whatever the journal prescribes in author's instructions must be adopted. And then cohesion and coherence. छोटी सी बात है, ज्यादा detail तो नहीं कर पाऊंगा इस समय. But cohesion means sentence level interlinking, sentence level relation. How one sentence is linked with the another sentence is called cohesion. It's a grammatical level glueness, you can say, stickiness. While the coherence is the idea level stickiness. Whether one idea is linked with another idea in a wonderful way or in a normal way, in a smooth way or not. So cohesion and coherence, these two things you must learn. And that's why we have been taught, we are being taught English in your undergrad first year, so that we can learn these things. However, cohesion and coherence is well ahead and quite, you know, advanced thing as compared to the simple English writing. So I request each of the institution, universities, departments of PG, postgrad level, they must have some classes on cohesion and coherence, how to introduce these things for improving the article writing aspect. The second thing is plagiarism. Oh, this is a ghost nowadays. You must learn concept, types, consequences, detection, and avoiding. Heck yeah. Your student had an article, or you have written some article, assignment, submitted to your mentor or supervisor. You have submitted to your mentor. Mentor has caught that it is a copy paste. Yes, this issue is plagiarism. It is called academic theft in simple language, I'm telling. However, plagiarism is entirely a different. I conduct many of the webinars and the training sessions for plagiarism, because detecting and avoiding plagiarism is an art as well as a science. Friends and moderators of the webinar, please note that because I'm delivering my lecture on the directly on the PPTs, I'm unable to see the chat box. So whatever the chat box is coming up with the things, please note them down and you can get back to me after the session. Okay. And I'll be having a break. Okay. Thank you. So friends, please note down this thing. You just paste University Grants Commission promotion of academic integrity and prevention of plagiarism. Plagiarism rule dal dijiye Google mein simple. Aapko ek PDF mil jayega. It is a Bible. It is a, you know, Rajdand jise kehte hain. Agar Hindi mein aap samjhe. Hua kya? Actually, hamare saath problem kya hai na? Jab tak hamare par koi भय भी नहीं हो ना प्रीति हमें किसी चीज से लगाव नहीं होता जब तक भय नहीं होता तो गवर्नमेंट ने सोचा कि प्लेजरिज्म सिखाना है तो दैट यू मस्ट कम अप विद वी मस्ट कम अप विद द गैजेट एंड देयर आर थ्री टियर पनिशमेंट सिस्टम इज देयर इफ यू आर कॉट इन द प्लेजरिज्म 0 to 10% नो पनिशमेंट इज देयर इफ 10 to 40% इज देयर देन पनिशमेंट लेवल इज 40 to 60 एंड अप बिफोर 60 आफ्टर अबव 60% इट मींस द कॉपी इफ द लेवल ऑफ कॉपी पेस्ट इज इन बिटवीन 10 to 40 40 to 60 और अबव 60% Not only the student, but also the supervisor will be punished. Sir, if you are a teacher, you may lose your increments, you may lose your supervisorship, you may lose your job even. If your student is caught in the is plagiarism. So be alert. This is very dangerous and double-edged sword. So you must learn again and concept. What is the concept of plagiarism? What are the types of plagiarism? What may be the consequences? You must know how you can detect the plagiarism and how you can avoid it. So you must learn from wherever you want to learn. Please do learn the things. There are so many things which are available for detecting and avoiding plagiarism. Okay. The next thing is getting the resources. No institute is there in India which is having each and everything in one single umbrella. You are reading and thinking. The prospective topics, the related body of knowledge, the brainstorming must be done. The literature review, the brainstorming is done with the help of what are the sources you have to identify of the literature review, the databases, methods, organization, research gap, origin of idea and aim or objective. What is you are doing that whatever the collection, it looks simple. Most of the people take it very lightly. But believe me, until you do a good literature and effective literature review, you can't deliver a good piece of research. Okay. And you cannot identify the research gap. You cannot go for the rationality. What is the rationale behind this? Then, aim and objective must be let down. The review papers, types of writing you must know. What are the different types of writing you are going to, you know, aspire for? What kind of thing you are going to write? Book, chapter, research proposals. You know, even the grant writing is an art. For faculty members, if you are going for, आपको डालना है project proposal लेना है कोई project grant लेना है वो writing अलग है इससे. Paper writing alag hai, thesis writing alag hai, and this is right. There are some basic concept may be similar, but some things, special things are required for the, and especially nowadays, massive open online courses, digital writing and OER development. I request some enthusiastic learners not to draw on my slides. Okay. OERs, open educational resources. Open educational and resources. As we know, whatever is freely available up to a standard mark, these open educational resources are freely available from which are the educational sources from various institutes, various platforms. Even the, you know, you will find very good educational resources from Facebook, YouTube, but it's on you how to filter them out for your learning, for your research. edX, Coursera, YouTube, Khan Academy, Udemy, and our own Swayam, Government of India's learning platform, Swayam, swayam.gov.in, in which I am also hosting two courses. I'll be letting you know, academic writing and industrial pharmacy. However, in this cycle, the enrollment date is gone, and many of the, I think the participants are also already doing my course on academic writing, for in which we have covered lot many things, including the general targeting in our 15-week course. For your quick reference, you can note it down, the cut.ly /OKLives. This is my channel, freely available lectures on open educational resources as well as academic writing is there. I have made the playlist for you. You just go there, you can, you know, subscribe. It is, I have no monetary intention behind this, just to share my things. I have kept them open so that आप सभी कुछ सीख सकें. और ये जो कुछ लेक्चर्स हैं, कुछ लेक्चर्स दे आर इन गुड मिक्स ऑफ इंग्लिश एंड हिंदी, दे आर माय रिकॉर्डेड लेक्चर्स ऑफ सम फैकल्टी डेवलपमेंट कोर्सेज एंड सम इन द टीचर्स ट्रेनिंग सेशंस, दिस हैव बीन रिकॉर्डेड एंड फ्रीली अवेलेबल फॉर यू. नेक्स्ट इज टारगेटिंग जर्नल, दिस जिसके बारे में आज बात करने वाले हैं. यू मस्ट नो व्हाट आर द जर्नल मैट्रिक्स, इंपैक्ट फैक्टर, साइट स्कोर, स्निप, एसजेआर, ऑथर मैट्रिक्स क्या होते हैं, एच इंडेक्स, जी इंडेक्स. यू मस्ट नो दिस थिंग बिकॉज दीज आर द थिंग्स विच विल गवर्न द सेलेक्शन ऑफ द जर्नल. आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग इट. सो बिफोर राइटिंग प्लान वेयर टू सेंड, दिस इज द एस्पेक्ट ऑफ जर्नल टारगेटिंग. आपका एम क्या है, आपको प्लानिंग करना है कि कहां मुझे आर्टिकल भेजना है. दैट इज अटमोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इट हैज गॉट द वाइटल वैल्यू इन योर रिसर्च वर्क. आई विल बी कवरिंग दिस थिंग. The last but not the least, there are a couple of more things dealing with the submission part, post-submission, team, collaboration, your research team, because you cannot do the research in isolation. You can't do the work in as a one-man army. You know, tuning between research scholar and supervisor must be very good. You know, having a good supervisor or getting a good student, both are blessings. Accept it. Okay. And you must have a good tune. Then you can plan for the good research. You can think of good research. Okay, it is utmost important. Time and team management. These are the four major things you can say. However, obviously the drafting you must know, other things you must. But these are the major things which I could compile that you should learn these things for academic writing. Now, I'll move to our core aspect as the time. Because when we are dealing with the online learning, online courses, we stick to the timeline. As जैसे कि मैंने आपको बोला था कि मैं 10-15 मिनट आपको बताऊंगा, उसके बाद डायरेक्टली जनरल टारगेटिंग पे मूव करूंगा. मेरा ईच एंड एवरी स्लाइड का जो टाइमिंग होता है वो ऑलमोस्ट फिक्स रहता है, सो दैट आई कैन कवर इट एंड आई कैन गिव यू, और डोंट वरी, आई विल गिव यू सफिशियंट टाइम फॉर इंटरेक्टिंग एंड पुटिंग योर क्वेश्चन. Because my presentation is always power-packed and condense them to the point. So let's move. Plan well on time. Jaisa ki maine sabse pehle kaha, timing is at most important. Start writing early. Timing dekha aapne? Skipping karte hai kabhi? Thodi si timing ka game hai na? Timing thoda sa pehle koodna hota hai. Little early you have to jump for skipping. And this little early, how much little early you have to jump? For skipping, you learn, and ये आपके उसमें आ जाता है. तो ऐसा ही research में, अगर research publication आपको लेना है, तो it must be in your heart, in your veins, it should be there. कि ना मुझे करना है, तो अगर मुझे paper चाहिए, तो मुझे आज काम करना. खाली paper से मतलब नहीं है, मैं इस चीज को नहीं मानता. आपका अपने whatever the work you have done, don't do it for APIs, don't do it for getting the, make it as a habit to present the thing in a good manner. So that you can become a well-known name in your research area, you can collaborate with other things. Okay, so timing is at most important. For review and research, obviously, ab review likhna hai, to kab tak wait karenge? Aap apne literature review kiya? Main to 3 mahine mein apne student ko, PG student ko bolta hu 2 mahine mein. Ki ek aaj ki date mein literature review karna 15 din ka kaam hai. It is hardly 1 week or 2 week task to do the literature review. Then you go for the review writing, and don't allow your student to do it lonely. You know, student should compile the things and present the thing before the supervisor, and the supervisor must give their expert opinion and though you can their inputs, and then they can plan their review well on time. And then whenever you have completed the earlier research experiments, go for short communication rather than going for the full paper. So in this way, you can have good on well on time, you can get your work published. Even hum M.Pharm mein bhi, jab aap PG karte hain, PG mein bhi log kehte hain, yaar ek saal mein hum kaise paper nikalenge? Aap nikaliye na. If you have done the literature review in 15 days, plan the review paper. I think it is possible to get one review and one research within M.Pharm if you follow the time schedule. Agar aap alert hain, if you are not wasting your time, and believe me, entire pharmacy PG research work, if a serious student is there, he or she can do the work within 4 weeks max. Rest of the thing, the time pass. Students are doing the time pass, or sorry to say, teachers are doing the time pass. If it is only for 1 year, what you are doing, the work which your student is doing, you ask yourself, how much time is needed if you are in there in lab, if you are a good researcher, if you know the things. Hardly 4 weeks, and 4 weeks, that too I'm telling more. It is, at the higher end. So why can't we have good research work and research papers? So plan the outline on time. Samay pe outline dijiye, thoda dimag ko kasht dijiye. Have some brainstorming. If you will plan the outline very sincerely, you can do the work. Now, where to publish? How we can target the journals? Kaise target karna hai journal ko? There are three factors. There are three factors of a journal. Elsewhere ka journal, Elsewhere ko credit mein deta hun cheez ke liye. Bahut acche dhang se usne cheez ko bataya hai ki impact. First thing is impact. What an impact a journal is having, we must see. Second thing is speed. How early your paper is being published, how frequently the journal is being published, okay, how much time is being taken in the peer review process, and then the reach of the journal to geographical areas, reach of the journal to various kind and various and the number of readers. That is the reach, impact, speed, and reach. Let us discuss these things a little bit in detail. So whatever the choice or expectation you are going to have, there are three criteria will fulfill: impact, speed, and reach. But I'm again repeating this thing, because in Indian scenario, I'm telling that you have to compromise one or two things for getting one particular aspect. If you want to go for impact, forget about the speed until you are spending the money. So money is the fourth domain, you can say. So because even the good journals, very good journals, they like Molecules, which are in providing the open access, which are the open access journal, they take a huge amount of publication fee, APs, article processing charges, or publishing fee. So they can publish your work in very less time, within 1 week, or within 2 weeks, or maximum one month. But you will have to spend the money. So whatever I'm telling is taking the thing, one thing constant, that you are not having money for spending in these things. In most of the cases, no researcher has that kind of money, because if you go for publishing Molecules journals, journals like Molecules, you will have to give your 1 year salary, or maybe 6 months salary, to get your paper published. So if you want good impact, you might become compromising speed, because many of the impact journals take at least 3 to 4 months to give the decision. Okay, so speed you have to compromise. If you want early publication, you may compromise, because higher impact never give the in very early time, irrespective of that constant. Okay, money gota dijiye. So speed, if you want early, then go for the journal which are having good indexing. They may not have impact factors. Okay, so compromise impact in case, or you can compromise reach. Reach is the factor. Say for example, you are going for a high frequency journal. Okay, or you are going for a multidisciplinary journal, you want to be cited more, or then you can write the review. So depending on that thing, say for example, current science in Indian scenario is having the impact factor around 0.2, 0.4 maybe max. Okay. But even though it is a very multidisciplinary journal and you will get a very good reach. If you are writing review, you will get very good reach as compared to writing a research paper. However, the things are different because the review papers sometimes are not even counted in some cases. Okay. So these are the gross scenario. Let us take them one by one. Impact. Are you ready to wait? Jaisa ki maine aapko bataya, if you want to get it published in good impact journal, are you ready to wait? Because impact means, what does the impact means? What kind of aura, prestige, impact a journal possesses? The quality supported with sound statistical indicators are there. Impact gives the confidence in the author for their selection of journal. If I'm publishing a journal, publishing an article in a journal which is having good impact, it means the credibility of researcher is good. You don't need to carry, you don't need to give the detail that yes, I'm having this work, I've done this research work. If you're getting published in Nature, wonderful. No one will ask you what you have done. Your work is already peer reviewed. So impact, then speed. I'll be discussing the impact factor, don't worry. Speed means rapid publication in reputed journals. It doesn't mean for rapid publication. Nowadays, many journals are there. Aajkal bahut sare journals hai jo raat aur raat kehte hain ki raat ko aap jama kar dijiye, 2000 rupaye jama kar dijiye, morning mein aapka paper chal jayega. So don't go for that much speed. Okay. So, and be aware of that predatory journals, so Tom, Dick and Harry journals, which are just making the money out of your pocket and even the things. I will let you know that please see the kind of journal you are approaching. Don't publish the journals in the journals which are not indexed in Scopus, Science Citation Index, Expanded Science Citation Index or Web of Science. इन चार पांच के अलावा जाइए ही मत, एंड फॉरगेट अबाउट द यूजीसी केयर लिस्ट. यूजीसी केयर लिस्ट में ये जर्नल तो होने ही है. ओके, सो यू टारगेट ऑन द द द हाईएस्ट पीक, यू टारगेट द माउंट एवरेस्ट. सो केयर लिस्ट इज विल ऑलरेडी बी कवर्ड, सो डोंट बॉदर अबाउट दैट. इट इज डायनेमिक लिस्ट. सो इफ यू सबमिट इन द टॉम डिक एंड हैरी जर्नल, यू माइट बी फाइंडिंग दैट इन फ्यू मंथ इट इज नॉट देयर इन द यूजीसी केयर लिस्ट. ओके, speed. Early rejection is far better than very late acceptance. This is my personal opinion. I love those journals which reject your paper within 24 hours because they are saving our time. And many times they give even the inputs. If they are rejecting your paper in 7 days or 10 days, they are giving the inputs which are very valuable for improving your manuscript. But speed, that rejection must come earlier. That's why I love the journals who reject the manuscript quickly rather than waiting for a journal for acceptance for 1 year and 2 years. Sorry to say, but I won't take the name, but the journals are there in the pharmacy. They're having the impact factor also, but they give their first decision in 5, 6 months or 8 months, and they will publish your work for 1 month or 1 year and 1.5 years. What to do for that publication which is not valuable for you? Time is invaluable, priceless. Researcher and you better understand its importance. When the thesis submission is pending just for one publication, aapka keval ek publication reh gaya thesis submit honi. Aapne kai case bhi dekhe honge, you might remember many examples around your PhD which are struggling for getting one paper on time at before the submission of your PhD. That's why the time is always invaluable. Not only just for PhD submission, it is always invaluable. Now moving to the reach, more people need readership. Aapko zyada logon tak pahunchana hai. You want to reach more and more people, and then only you will be cited more. You will be read more. For that, reach factor is utmost important. reaching people is at most important. Reaching to the researcher who are interested in your work, it is at most important. So again, impact, speed, and reach. Be crystal clear and choose the parameter which is required for you. And don't try to put your legs in all three boards put together. Otherwise, you will be lost. Okay. So what I see, what I request you, that if you are having money, then that's very good. But in an Indian scenario, I don't think so anyone is having that much money to put in your for publication. So yeah, this we have covered right there. Now, targeting a journal. I have told you to enlist a journal, enlist journals which are required for paper publication. Authors cannot go through all the prospective journals. ऐसा नहीं हो सकता ना कि आप सारे जर्नल को पलटना लग जाओ यार इसमें मेरे रिलेटेड आर्टिकल आए हैं मैं क्या कितने देर में छपता आप हर एक चीज नहीं देख पाएंगे कितने जर्नल आप चेक करेंगे. The benchmark matrices is needed to save the time. For that matrices are there जो बताती हैं कि भाई ये जो जर्नल है ये सही है. Before go, it doesn't require to go into the detail of each and every article of which are published with the passage of time in that particular journal. कितने जर्नल के कितने आर्टिकल देख पाएंगे आप. For that you need matrices. जिससे पता चले कि हाँ ये जर्नल अच्छा है ये जर्नल उतना अच्छा नहीं है. That benchmarking can be done with the help of matrices. So what are these journal matrices? Impact factor, ISI ranking, site score metrics, Egan factor, article influence, AI, immediacy index, SNIP, source normalized impact per paper, SJR, Simago journal rank, and ALT metrics. These are the important journal metrics. However, due to interest of time, I'll be covering only the impact factor in little bit detail. Rest, you are welcome to see the various resources in the elsewhere site. You go, you will get all the details. Okay. And H5 is also a journal metrics. Now going to the author metrics. It was about the journals. Now you want to follow a particular journal. आप किसी author को देखना चाहते हैं जिसने काम किया है, ठीक है? So what you will see? H index. क्या होता है H index? बताता हूँ आपको because in later section I am not going to detail about the H index. H index when you go for the Google profile, number of articles published number of times provides H index. Say for example, my H index is 24. It means each of my 24 papers are cited at least 24 times or more. If you are having H index 10, it means each of your 10 papers out of your entire publication are published at least 10 or more times. ठीक है? यानी आपके 10 अगर आपका H index 10 है तो इसका मतलब आपका हर एक 10 paper 10 या 10 से अधिक बार cite किया गया है, refer किया गया है. More the H index, more is the credibility of researcher. Okay, especially for the biomedical researchers, H index, जो physicists थे, Hertz, 2005 का concept है, for biomedical researcher, it should be equivalent to your service years, experience. If you are having 10 years of experience, you must have H index of 10, if you are a good researcher. If it is not 10, you are below average researcher. If it is more than 10, for the person, if you are say, I'm taking this thing, if you are having 10 years of experience, then it must be about 10. If it is about 10, then you are an extraordinary researcher. So this is a simple thing. However, this thing doesn't apply in arts, humanities, and others. It applies in sciences, biomedicals, physics, chemistry, etc. Okay, life sciences, it works very well. But in arts and humanity, it doesn't work very well, this particular index. Okay. I10 index is the immediacy index. Another, this H index you can see in the Google profile, in the Google Scholar profile, you can see the H index of a particular person if he has or she has published his or her or opened his or her profile public. G-index is a modified H-index, however, it is not much used. I-10 index shows the immediacy index. Okay, yeah, this is that it is also given by the Google Scholar. Scholar map takes the I-10 index. So, now moving to the impact factor. जो मिथ है ना इम्पैक्ट फैक्टर का, हालांकि देखिए इम्पैक्ट फैक्टर के बारे में एक मोटी बात को बताऊं कि इट इज, चलिए शुरुआत करते हैं कि मोस्ट इम्पोर्ट, इट इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट बेसिस फॉर सेलेक्शन ऑफ जर्नल, मीजर फॉर द रेपुटेशन ऑफ अ जर्नल, ओके, मीजर फॉर द फ्रीक्वेंसी विद विच द एवरेज आर्टिकल इन ए जर्नल हैज बीन साइटेड इन अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया. ये डेफिनेशन है सिंपल, विकिपीडिया में भी मिल जाएगी आपको, विकिपीडिया की डेफिनेशन है. ए जर्नल इम्पैक्ट फैक्टर इज प्रेजेंटेड बाय ए डिजिट, हमें एक डिजिट से करते हैं. जैसे मैंने एक एग्जाम्पल दिया आपको, एक्सपर्ट ओपिनियन ट्रैक पेंथम का एक बहुत अच्छा जर्नल है, फॉलोड बाय ईयर, वो पहले बताता है डिजिट उसके बाद ईयर एंड देन प्रोवाइडिंग एजेंसी का नाम ऑन द होम पेज ऑफ एक्सपर्ट ओपिनियन ट्रैक डिग्री. आप क्लिक कीजिए आपको होम पेज मिल जाएगा. जैसे 2017 का इंपैक्ट फैक्टर, अब तो मेरी स्लाइड ये थोड़ा पुरानी है, मैंने नया उसको अपडेट नहीं किया, कि 2017 इंपैक्ट फैक्टर 5.53 कॉपीराइट क्लैरिबेट एनालिटिक्स 2018 रिलीज ऑफ द जर्नल साइटेशन रिपोर्ट. बाय दिस By this, we can have the you can have an idea that what is the impact factor of that particular journal given by an agency. Impact factor is a dynamic index. Remember this thing. Remember my word. This is a dynamic index. It increases or decreases every year. कोई कांस्टेंट नहीं रहता है इंपैक्ट फैक्टर, क्योंकि वो वेरी करता है. किससे वेरी करता है? इट डिपेंड्स ऑन टोटल नंबर ऑफ पब्लिकेशन, टोटल साइटेशन ऑफ ए जर्नल. इफ एनी गिवन ईयर में द इंपैक्ट फैक्टर ऑफ ए जर्नल इज द नंबर ऑफ साइटेशंस रिसीव्ड इन दैट ईयर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स पब्लिश्ड इन दैट जर्नल ड्यूरिंग द टू प्रीसीडिंग ईयर्स डिवाइडेड बाय द टोटल नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स पब्लिश्ड इन दैट जर्नल ड्यूरिंग द टू प्रीसीडिंग ईयर्स. कहने का मतलब यह है कि टोटल साइटेशन ऑफ लास्ट दो साल के डिवाइडेड बाय टोटल पब्लिकेशन लास्ट दो साल. सो यू कैन कैलकुलेट दैट इंपैक्ट फैक्टर 2017 कैसे आया, तो आप यू कैन कैलकुलेट द थिंग. ठीक है, आपको कैलकुलेशन पे जाना नहीं है ना कैलकुलेशन करनी है, ये बात तो मैंने केवल आपको इसलिए बताया कि यू माइट बी आस्क्ड इन योर वाइवा और योर इंटरव्यूज, इट इज आस्क्ड समटाइम. So you should be able in condition to answer this thing. But these impact factors are given by only the validated agencies, verified like Thomas Reuters, Journal Citation Report, JCR, Clarivate Analytics, the Institute of Scientific Information, ISI, Scopus SJR, CiteScore. So, मोटा मोटा मैं आपको बता दूँ, JCR और CiteScore. CiteScore भी एक तरह का impact factor है जो प्रोवाइड किया जाता है स्कोपस से. तो साइट स्कोर या फिर क्लैरिवेट एनालिटिक्स, दीज आर द टू इंपॉर्टेंट. इन बायोमेडिकल रिसेप्ट में बात कर रहा हूं तो केवल इनका मानिए, बाकी डॉक्टर सेमल्टी ने अपना जर्नल निकाला और डॉक्टर सेमल्टी ने जो है सितंबर में जो अपना जर्नल लॉन्च किया, दिसंबर में उन्होंने कहा कि हमारा जो इंपैक्ट फैक्टर 12 है, अपने आप डिक्लेयर किया, स्वयंभू कमांडर बन गए. तो डॉक्टर सेमल्टी रॉन्ग है, डोंट फॉल इन द प्रे ऑफ दीज थिंग्स, दीज जर्नल्स. ये जो स्वयंभू कमांडर्स होते हैं जर्नल्स के, कि मेरा इंपैक्ट फैक्टर ये है, अलाना है, फलाना है, अपनी कैलकुलेशन करते हैं, डोंट गो इनटू द कैलकुलेशन. ठीक है, तो आप अपने को नोबल भी दे दीजिए, फिर तो नोबल प्राइज दे दीजिए कि आई हैव गॉट द नोबल प्राइज. ओके, सो इट इज जस्ट अवार्डिंग योरसेल्फ. ओके, सो इंडेक्सिंग एजेंसी, ये इंपैक्ट फैक्टर मिलता कैसे? देयर आर सर्टेन इंडेक्सिंग एजेंसीज जिसमें कि उस जर्नल का इंडेक्स होना ही अपने में बड़ी बात होती है. ये मैं किस लिए बता रहा हूँ, व्हाई आई एम टेलिंग यू, लाइक चलिए पहले नाम गिन लेते हैं, साइंस साइटेशन इंडेक्स SCI और एक्सपेंडेड साइंस साइटेशन इंडेक्स ESCI. इफ जर्नल इज इंडेक्सिंग SCI, ESCI, ISI, PubMed, इन बायोमेडिकल में आप जाते हैं, अगर कोई जर्नल PubMed में इंडेक्स है तो इट मींस गुड. उसका अगर वो इंपैक्ट फैक्टर भी नहीं है तो कोई बात नहीं, वेल एंड गुड. जैसे करंट ड्रग डिस्कवरी टेक्नोलॉजी है, आई एम द एडिटर देयर, कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट मत समझिएगा, मैं केवल एग्जांपल इसलिए बता रहा हूँ कि व्हाई आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट इट इज नॉट हैविंग द इंपैक्ट फैक्टर बट इट इज इंडेक्स इन PubMed. ओके, It means later or sooner it will get the impact factor. So if you are unable to target a good impact journal, at least target the journal which is having good indexing. Indian Drugs is indexed in Scopus. Sab jante hain Indian Drugs biomedical wale. IDMA ka journal hai, Indian Drug Manufacturing Association. It is indexed in Scopus. It is very old journal, you know very well. Keval impact factor isliye nahi hai kyunki us samay pehle hi online aaya hai. Usse pehle offline tha. To journal ke liye impact factor hone ka very first prerequisite is that each and every journal must be online first. No offline journal can't have the impact factor. It cannot have impact factor if it is not online. That's why Indian Drugs is not having, but Indian Drugs is the best choice. I always publish at least one paper in a year in Indian Drugs. Because at least the reach is good to my Indian fellow citizens for the taxpayers' money. So whatever the record, I can publish in Indian journal, but I have a commitment that out of my yearly publication, I publish at least one paper in a national journal so that my fellow citizens take the advantage of the research which have been done from their pocket, because it's a taxpayer's money which I'm getting in the form of project. It is my responsibility. This is my thinking. Social Science Citation Index, SSCI. Social Science Citation Index. Remember this thing, SSCI. This is also a very good indexing agency. PubMed, Web of Science, Scopus, Embase, Chemical Abstract, ISI, Index Copernicus, SciFactor, ICI, Google Scholar. Google Scholar पे मत जाइएगा. Last में सबसे slip बोला है क्योंकि whatever is there in online, आप कोई journal पैदा होते ही Google Scholar में index होता है क्योंकि whatever is online, it will be reflecting the Google Scholar. So Google Scholar is not an indexing agency. Google Scholar is kind of indexing search engine, you can say. But these are the indexing agency. Nowadays, journal claim that it is indexed in Google Scholar. Google Scholar automatically लेता है, कोई index नहीं करता. But to get indexed in SCI and EXCI, it is not an automatic process. Only the good quality journals are indexed in SCI, ESCI, Scopus, Web of Science. Always publish. Citation keep information दी रहती है. अगर impact factor है, in the landing page, the impact factor will be given. Okay? And just rely on the landing page of the prestigious publishers journal only. Otherwise, कोई भी journal के landing page पे आप believe मत कीजिए. Okay? I will show you the simple way also that just if any journal is there, na, if any genuine journal there, it is having impact factor. Just type the name in the Google search bar and type that name and impact factor. If it is having genuine impact factor, it will be shown in the box. Like expert opinion drug will be डालेगा impact factor. वो दिखेगा. उसके अलावा किसी Tom, Dick and Harry journal का नाम डालिए जो बताता है कि मेरा impact factor 12 है, 10 है, 10 है, 12 है. उसका नाम नहीं आएगा. Bhali, it might be possible that the impact factor shown by the Google app in that way will be older one, but at least the genuineness will be proven. This is the simplest thing. However, because these reports of JCR and all that are paid one, so you won't get the reports of the impact factors until you are having the paid subscription. So once these journals are indexed in these indexing services, agencies like Clarivate keep track of those citations and publication and then provide impact factor time to time. Aur har saal July mein milta hai. Har saal July mein JCR jo hai, journal citation report releases in the month of July. Okay, in the month of July. So for example, in 2018 July, the impact factor 2017 was released. Ab 2020 mein 2019 ka impact factor release hua hai. कई जर्नल जो स्वयंभू कमांड होते हैं भूल जाते हैं कि 2020 में 2020 का इंपैक्ट फैक्टर नहीं आता है. ओके, जो लोग ये धंधा चला रहे हैं वो भी सीख लें कि जो झूठ बोलना है तो जरा ढंग से बोलें. ओके, द बिजनेस शुड नॉट बी इन दैट वे. सो सेल्फ डिक्लेरेशन ऑफ इंपैक्ट फैक्टर बाय जर्नल इज नॉट वैलिड. दीज एजेंसीज आर ग्लोबली रिकॉग्नाइज्ड फॉर एनालाइजिंग एंड रिलीजिंग द इंपैक्ट फैक्टर. इंपैक्ट फैक्टर इन जर्नल डिपेंड्स ऑन नंबर ऑफ पेपर्स पब्लिश्ड एंड साइटेशंस. इफ a journal is having good number of papers published, then there are good chances of getting the impact factor. Presence in various indexing agencies, which we have discussed. Frequency of publications. Bhai, koi journals 2 saal mein ek baar chhap raha hai. If a journal is being published quarterly, and if it is journal publishing monthly, and if a journal is publishing fortnightly, and quality papers are being published, then the journal which is having higher frequency has the higher chances, greater chances of getting the impact factor, because it will have more, it has a greater chance of good number of citations. It has got a good reach. Okay. So online nature and wide dissemination at open access. If the journal is open access, it is freely providing all the full text material. All people will be freely citing it. So there are good chances. The more the citations, more will be the impact factor. Okay. Simple thing. Publisher's policy of self-citation. Some publisher have the self, however, it is little bit unethical, but the publisher who have the self-citation policies sometimes get the advantage. Nature of journal, if a journal is review only, aapko pata hai, advanced drug delivery reviews ka jo impact factor hai, wo hamesa interest journal of pharmaceutics ke upar kyun rehta hai? In pharmacy aspect, advanced drug delivery reviews, good journal from elsewhere, interest journal of pharmaceutics. In every year, you will get ADDR is having very good impact factor as compared to IJP, because ADDR only publishes reviews and reviews are cited more. So that's why the journals which publish only the review or good review, number of reviews are higher there, which are freely available, that too are having the good impact factor. Miscellaneous factor may also be there. There yahi factor nahi hai. There are so many, or even the interdisciplinary journals. Yes, interdisciplinary journals are having good reach, so they are cited more. Miscellaneous factor kya hai? Manuscript, presentation, editorial quality. There are so many. So assess your work wisely. ये मैं सोची कि एंटीऑक्सीडेंट एक्टिविटी निकाली है और मैं नेचर में पब्लिश करने चला हूँ, या मैंने साइक्लोडेक्सिन कॉम्प्लेक्स बनाया और इससे सॉल्युबिलिटी बढ़ी और मैं आईजीपी में भेज दूंगा, इंटरस्टेलर फार्मास्यूटिकल्स में भेज दूंगा. नो, असेस योर वर्क वाइजली. नीदर ओवर एस्टिमेट नॉर अंडर एस्टिमेट योर वर्क. ओके, सो टारगेट जर्नल वाइजली, टारगेट क्वालिटी जर्नल्स फॉर जर्नल्स विद गुड इम्पैक्ट और इंडेक्सिंग. इम्पैक्ट में छापना है कि इंडेक्सिंग में छापना है? इम्पैक्ट, स्पीड एंड रीच, दीज आर द थ्री फैक्टर्स जो आपको गवर्न करेंगे. Matching with the scope of the journal. देखिए, इस चीज को बताता हूं. बच्चा जो है लॉयन के साथ खेल रहा है, टाइगर के साथ खेल रहा है, कि मैचिंग विद द स्कोप ऑफ जर्नल इज अटमोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट. डोंट पब्लिश, सी व्हाट काइंड ऑफ आर्टिकल्स इट रिसीव्स, बट सी व्हाट काइंड ऑफ आर्टिकल ए जर्नल पब्लिशेस, देन ओनली कम्युनिकेट इट. Why are you wasting your time if a journal doesn't publish that kind of manuscript which you are going to, which are trying it to publish? Okay, so don't play with the tiger. So see article processing charges, which I maintained, I have put that constant before you again. If you are having money, publish it, use it for good journals only, that too, not to Tom, Dick and Harry journals. Predatory journals mein use mat kijiye money ko. You can use money if you are having for giving the article processing charges or fast track mode. Even the very good journal provide a fast track mode processing, which is not a guarantee of publication. Even the APC, article processing charge, is not a guarantee of accepting a paper in good journal. Halanki in predatory journal, in Tom, Dick and Harry, it is always a guarantee. When you giving the money, they will publish. So this is a difference between the good journals and the bad journals. So if you are having $50, $100, and sometimes journal take up to $300 as the article processing charges, you can go ahead with that if you are having the money. So you will get the answer, you will get the result at least in earlier time frame. So target a journal which takes less time for publication. See, it is written there, received on, revised on, accepted on in every journal's article's first page. Search it, okay, and then target it. Then choose the type of article. If you are having this with the scope of the journal, you can plan the article as either full length, short comment. If you are having a short piece of article, in you have done 2 months or 3 months work, you have got a little piece of work, then try to write the short communication. Don't write the full paper now. Try the short commission. Short commission has the equal weight as compared to the full research article. Don't worry about that. So go for short communication. They will be rather published in a shorter time frame. Okay. So again, summarizing, impact, speed, and reach. These are the three major factors. Choose as per your requirement. So in the I'm going to end my lecture in 2-3 minutes. I'm giving you these links. I'll be posting if you want that these links. However, in my open, this is not required. In OK Live, if you go, there's an entire playlist I have made, which is the compilation of all my some of my lecture, including in Hindi as well as in English, about the academic writing, in which I have discussed many more things about the academic writing. So this is the playlist. If you think, I'll be discussing the thing after my in Q&A session, I'll be posting these links for you in the chat box. And this is my course on academic writing, about which, however, this enrollment are closed and we are running in the last week of this cycle. This is our last week chal raha hai. So our learners are enjoying the things and we have promised to trigger and excel and academic writing. Even in every state of India, I'm having my learner. I'm proud to have my learners in each and every state and almost in every institute. More than 35,000 learners from 95 countries I'm having put together all the three cycles of this course, academic writing. On the Swayam platform, Swayam ke baare mein agar nahi jante hain to swayam.gov, Swayam ka bhi ek promotion ka maine ek OK Live mein banaya apne channel mein, usko dekhiye aur janiye ki Swayam mein massive open online courses are freely available, the free digital contents are available. This is our team, this team of academic writing, my better half and Dr. Mona Simulty from my department, physics department, sir, Professor Rajat Agrawal, IIT Roorkee, from Department of Business Management. This is the team AW. So we have achieved many more milestones nationally and internationally. Our course is being liked, being float in the African countries as well as all the Western world. The academic writing is in the world ranking, and we have been appreciated by the Ministry of Education. So agli cycle mein hi sahi aiyega, judiyega hamare saath, aur it's completely free for learning. Okay, and just for examination, aapko jo hai 1000 rupees fees deni padti, that too through government, okay, not me. Aur usme aapko Swayam aur NPTEL ke jo hai certificate bhi milta hai, and credit transfer le sakte hain industrial pharmacy ke liye. I have prepared a first pharmacy course of India, industrial pharmacy, which is on the basis of fifth semester of PCI syllabi, industrial pharmacy first, and it is also running in this cycle. We are the pioneer in pharmacy MOOC in India, the first MOOC of pharmacy for student, teachers, researcher, industry personnel. So join us in next cycle, maybe. However, this cycle mein to enrollment close ho chuke hain, and many students, more than 5,000 students, faculty members, researchers, industry person has joined us in this course in this cycle. We are proud that we got a huge response after the first cycle. In the first cycle, it was 2,500 plus learners. Okay, inki bhi main link aapko dunga. Swayam Prabha is a charan, being a Swayam mentor, course coordinator of two courses, this is my responsibility that to let you know about the Swayam Prabha. It is Swayam Prabha, jaise DTH channels hote hain na, 32 channels ka ek group hai, alag alag subject ke liye alag alag devoted hai, and unke apne YouTube channel bhi. वो डीटीएच चैनल से मिलता भी है. इफ यू आर हैविंग जियो सिम, तो जियो सिम में, जियो टीवी में अगर जाएंगे तो यू विल गेट दिस Swayam Prabha चैनल. Swayam Prabha चैनल नंबर 15 इज बाय आईआईटी मद्रास. सो वी हैव गॉट असाइनमेंट ड्यूरिंग द लॉकडाउन, द एंटायर लॉकडाउन वी प्रिपेयर्ड द थिंग इन द ओके लाइव. अगेन दिस चैनल इंपॉर्टेंट है, cut.ly/okelive. सो यू विल गेट टू प्लेलिस्ट देयर, सेमल्टी एनडीडीएस एंड सेमल्टी कॉस्मेटिक्स. Okay, even if you put it on YouTube, you will get this series of lectures there. Around, it is 25 hours of lectures are there on both of the topics put together. And around 30 hours of more lectures we are also going to come up. We chal raha hai production ka kaam. So Swayam Prabha ke liye humne NDDS ke liye, ab is samay 7th semester ke jo students hain, we from 7th semester, Nova Drug Review System, they can enjoy our lectures. The entire syllabi is covered in that particular, and that too freely available. Okay, this is my course, online teaching and learning. If you are interested, it is available in the Pharma State Academy. You just put the Pharma State Academy online teaching and learning, and if you apply this code, it's all, but it is paid AJIND 020, so avail RS 200 rupees discount you can have. some other research proposal granting. These are the courses which are on the paid platform. So coming to the end, the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do. And I believe that we will make the change. So thanks a lot from Garhwal University. This is my beautiful university in the lap of the Himalayas, near the bank of the river Alaknanda Central University. Thanks a lot from Garhwal University. And you can follow me at, I have the my own website, livingimpact.org. Facebook page, Dr. Semalt. Dr. Semalt, you can add Dr. Semalt, you can see and you can follow me. And my email ID, semaltaj@gmail.com. Thank you for being with me. I'm stopping sharing now. And meanwhile, I'll be taking all the questions. So enough time I have left for you for good Q&A. So over to moderators. Thank you. Yes, but I have a Q&A. If you are having any questions, I welcome any question from your side. Meanwhile, I'll be Bhagyashree. Your mic is off. Your mic is muted. You open your mic first.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your valuable knowledge with us. Definitely, it will help us in our academic career. Now, I would like to request Dr. Jeevan Dhumar, sir, to please initiate the question answer session.
Thank you, sir, for very good information. Many questions we have received from Zoom platform and from YouTube platform.
Yeah, bataiye. Welcome.
The first question is from Dr. Upendra Galgatti, Modern College of Pharmacy. He is asking that many researchers can't pay high publication fee of highly reputed journal. On the other hand, if they wanted to publish in highly reputed free of cost journal, there is a heap of manuscripts. So this delays publication. How to weigh out the situation?
No, friends, in my entire career, I haven't paid even a single penny in publishing an article. First, research is about passion. It is about patience. It is about perseverance. If you are running for numbers in publication, you are ethically wrong. Run for quality. Don't run for quantity, number one. And forget about what other people are doing unethically. Do it in the right way and draw your longer line rather than running for the hunger of publication. Don't go with that. If you do the quality research work now, the publication will automatically come. You need not to run for that. Just I told you the thing, the key is timing. The key is timing. It means have a good timeline in your mind that in first 6 months, this student or I have to prepare this thing and then I will prepare this research article and they will automatically come. I have followed this timeline even for my project work, not just for publication. In my entire career, just you forget the initial 3 years, I was having the projects. Otherwise, since 2007, I am having continuously research projects in my hand because the timing is important. So just see the timing, your honest effort. There are n number of good journals. You need to target good journals which can have publications. If you don't have money, publish in Indian Drugs. It's a wonderful journal. Index in Scopus. Okay. Index in Scopus. When the recruitment process is there, they ask for the Scopus Index journals. They don't ask for Impact journals. Scopus, Web of Science, and these Science Citation Index journals. They will. The time has come. If you apply for IITs, they just count the papers which are published in Scopus and Science Citation Index or ESCI or Web of Science. Otherwise, no article is taken in your list. So forget about even the UGC care list. Even. Just focus on these things. Okay, next.
Okay. Next question. This is from my side. What is the author, order of authors in the multi-author scientific publication? And the question with that is single author versus multiple ones, which have more values?
Dekhi, what I would like to tell you, if you are a faculty member, so my request is, until you are doing the PhD, don't put your name as a first author. Give the first authorship as an ethical way. The first authorship is the right of your student, is the right of your research scholar. It is not the right of your supervisor. Supervisor can be the corresponding author, doesn't matter. Rather, if you say in journal, you will see that the junior most person is the first author and the senior most person is the last author. Okay. And in the API scoring system, the first author as well as the corresponding author has the equal right, equal numbering. So why you are killing the opportunity of your student for being the first author? So please, I request you, don't be so hungry for first authorship. First authorship is equal to the corresponding authorship. So corresponding author baniye aur apne student ko first authorship dijiye multiple authorship mein. Okay. And don't neither take nor give the gift authorship. It may give you a very great trouble. Okay. Don't give the contrary party. Aajkal ek naya challenge chala hai. Yaar, 1000 rupees तुम दे दो, 1000 तुम दे दो, 2000 तुम दे दो और मिलके पेपर छाप लेते हैं और उस पेपर में पता चला 5-7 पेज का पेपर है, उसमें 25 ऑथर हैं, 25 ऑथर्स आर देयर, दे हैव कंट्रीब्यूटेड लाइक कंट्री पार्टी, टी पार्टी, दे हैव कंट्रीब्यूटेड इन देयर पब्लिशिंग इन द जर्नल्स. इवन दो यू विल हैव टू फेस द क्वेश्चंस, द बम्बार्डमेंट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस ऑफ द रिव्यूअर्स ऑफ द सॉरी दैट पैनल, दे विल से आप ऑथर नंबर 23 को जानते हो क्या, author number 24 ko jante ho gaya, you don't know even the author, you know, you are contributing, it means, or single authorship hona bhi, bhai maine kaam kiya, mere ko 17 saal ka anubhav hai, research work maine akele kiya kya, single authorship kaise ho sakti hai, how it is possible, so you will have to defend the single authorship achhi tab hai, aapne koi review likha, aur apne aap likha hai, to main maan sakta hu, it is, you know, chalega, justified hai. लेकिन रिसर्च इज नॉट, आपने अपने आप किया का काम, आपको आप बता सकते हैं क्या, यू नो, रिसर्च रिक्वायर्स ए गुड टीम एफर्ट. इवन द पीपल आर आस्क्ड हु आर द सिंगल ऑथर दैट हाउ यू हैव डन दिस वर्क, डू यू गेट द टाइम फॉर द रिसर्च फॉर डूइंग योर ओन, हैव यू डन इट एट योर ओन. रिव्यू मैं मान सकता हूं, कोई रिव्यू सिंगल ऑथर हो सकता है, पर रिसर्च एक्सपीरियंस लेवल पे नहीं हो सकता. अगर हो सकता है तो उसको डिफेंड करना चाहिए और इट शुड मस्ट बी डिफेंडेड. ओके, सो आई रिक्वेस्ट अगेन, मैं सभी को रिक्वेस्ट करता हूं, अपने स्टूडेंट को, चाहे वो एमफार्म भी है, आपने पीएचडी अगर कर लिया उस टॉपिक पे, अगर पीएचडी आपका है तो चलो मैं मान सकता हूँ फर्स्ट ऑथरशिप कर लीजिए, उससे भी कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग ऑथर रही. अगर आप पीएचडी नहीं है तो आपको क्या दिक्कत है, अपने स्टूडेंट को दीजिए, स्टूडेंट को राइट दीजिए फर्स्ट ऑथर होने का, यू बी द कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग ऑथर. Okay, thank you.
The next question is from MPharm student Malesh Prajapati. He is asking how to check and avoid plagiarism. And the similar question is asked by another student, that how much percentage of plagiarism is considered for review article publication?
No, friends, plagiarism apne mein ek bahut bada topic hai. मैं ज्यादा तो नहीं बता पाऊंगा इस बारे में, क्योंकि मैं प्लेजरिज्म के 3-3 घंटे के सेशन लेता हूँ, 3-3, 4-4 घंटे के सेशन लेता हूँ, तब भी वो पूरा नहीं हो पाता है. एनीवे, मैं थोड़ा सा समराइज करूंगा आपको कि
कि रिव्यू आर्टिकल हो चाहे कोई भी आर्टिकल, पहले तो आपको यह प्रयास रहना चाहिए कि यू शुड राइट इन योर ओन वे, अपनी तरह से लिखिए, ठीक है, और अपने आप उसको प्रेजेंट कीजिए, डोंट कॉपी पेस्ट। प्लेजरिज्म क्या है? एक एकेडमिक थेफ्ट है। तो आई रिक्वेस्ट द मॉडरेटर, जो बीच में जो लिंक जो मैं पेस्ट कर रहा हूँ वो यूट्यूब चैनल में भी डाल दीजिएगा, ताकि ठीक है, ताकि सबको शेयर हो जाए। खैर, डिटेक्शन के लिए देयर आर सो मेनी सॉफ्टवेयर्स अवेलेबल, ठीक है, कितनी चीज अलाउड है। तो पहले तो ये क्वेश्चन जो है, अलाउड का मतलब होता है कि ये वही है कि सर कितने पैसे की जो है, कितने रुपए की चोरी जो है अलाउड है, 10 रुपए की अलाउड है, 100 रुपए की अलाउड है, देखिए चोरी चोरी है, ठीक है। तो प्लेजरिंग तो अलाउड है ही नहीं, पहले तो एक क्वेश्चन मार्क क्वेश्चन गलत है कि अलाउड कितना है, तो अलाउड तो है ही नहीं ना, प्लेजरिंग तो होना ही नहीं चाहिए पहली बात, ठीक है। इन एनी वे हाउएवर इन प्रैक्टिकल टर्म्स सम थिंग्स कांट बी अवॉइडेड, सो दैट्स व्हाई अप टू 10% इज एग्जेम्प्टेड एज पर द प्लेजरिंग रूल 2018 ऑफ यूजीसी, 10% तक एग्जेम्प्टेड है, उसमें कोई पेनल्टी नहीं लगती, ध्यान दीजिएगा, वो अलाउड नहीं है, उसने कहा है, प्लेजरिंग रूल कहता है, द व्हाट द प्लेजरिंग रूल सेज that up to 10% there is no punishment, उसने punishment exempt किया, ये ध्यान रखिएगा इस चीज को, okay? So, हो सकता है आने वाले समय में उसी 10% में आप नब जाए, आपकी नौकरी नब जाए, आपका बच्चा नब जाए, ये मैं बता रहा हूँ, ये गारंटी नहीं है बचने की, ये है कि थीसिस के लिए ओके चल सकता है। और रिव्यू पेपर मोस्ट ऑफ द जर्नल्स टेक ए ग्रेटर रेंज ऑफ 15%, नॉट मोर देन 15% इज अलाउड इन एनी जर्नल, most of I haven't seen any journal which allow more than 15% of plagiarism or similarity in any case, okay? So you can use detection softwares like Urukund is there, Urukund is available to all the universities freely from InfibNet, government of India provide karte InfibNet pe type kijiyega, aapko freely available hota hai, faculty members ko freely available hai, theek hai, and even the for the private institute it is freely available, you just have to approach to the Ahmedabad InfibNet center, they will provide you all the things, okay? Iske alawa Turnitin hai, Authenticate hai, so many softwares are available, avoiding ke liye bhi bahut software available hai, par but best thing is you should be capable enough to avoid the plagiarism in your own. The software can only paraphrase the thing for you, there are the softwares available for paraphrasing, but unko they may change the contextual meaning. Contextual meaning बताऊं आपको क्या होता है, मैं भी ट्रांसलेट कर रहा था इंडस्ट्रियल फार्मेसी को, इंडस्ट्रियल फार्मेसी में चल रहा था, टैबलेट पंचिंग का मॉड्यूल था, तो बस ट्रांसलेटिंग थी, तो गूगल ट्रांसलेट ने, वो माइक्रोसॉफ्ट ट्रांसलेटर ने ट्रांसलेट किया, तो वह घूसे मारता है और वह मर जाता है, क्या था कि पंच कम्स फ्रॉम अपर साइड एंड इट एंटर्स इनटू द डाई वेल, ओके, सो उसने डाई को मरना कर दिया और पंच को घूसा कर दिया, तो कॉन्टेक्चुअल मीनिंग कंप्लीट चेंज हो गया। So when you are talking about the thing, about the technical things, you cannot rely on the softwares completely. आपको अपना ब्रेन लगाना पड़ेगा। उसके लिए तरीका है paraphrasing, सबसे पहला quoting, पहले तो जो चीज आप ऐसा ले रहे हैं, अगर pharmacopoeia definition ले रहे हैं तो under quote में रखें, double quote में रखें, single quote, double quote, use the direct quotation, then paraphrasing, plagiarism भी है और उसके बचने का तरीका भी है। आपको उस तरह से उसको अलग ढंग से प्रेजेंट करना है, उसको अपने ढंग से प्रेजेंट करना है, दैट इज कॉल्ड पैराफ्रेजिंग। पैराफ्रेजिंग के बाद जो है समराइजिंग है, कि यू आर समराइजिंग द थिंग्स इन योर ओन वे, इन योर ओन लैंग्वेज, मीनिंग बात वही कह रहे हैं लेकिन अपने शब्दों में बोल रहे हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड समराइजिंग। एंड देन रेफरेंसिंग, आप रेफरेंसिंग कीजिए हर बार, इन तीनों चीजों के साथ में रेफरेंस, तो जब ये तीन चार चीजें मिलती हैं, we can avoid, कोई एक चीज से आप plagiarism को रिमूव नहीं कर सकते, आपको दो या तीन चीज कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री करनी पड़ती है, ठीक है, थैंक
यू सर। शैल आई टेक फ्यू मोर क्वेश्चंस?
हां या प्लीज।
दिस इज क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम डॉक्टर नीलिमा ठोमरे, शी इज आस्किंग अबाउट इफ आवर रिसर्च वर्क इज जेन्युइन बट स्टिल इट हैपेंस, गुड जर्नल्स डोंट एक्सेप्ट, एंड द सिमिलर क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम Professor Suhas Ghodekar, he is asking that can we publish paper with negative results and how to present unreliable results when writing a research article?
देखिए जो पहला क्वेश्चन है, don't be, मैंने कहा ना patience, patience is the key, इन रिसर्च में जो है पेशेंस बहुत बड़ी चीज है। क्यों कह रहा हूं कि ये कोई गारंटी नहीं है कि जर्नल बहुत अच्छा है, पेपर बहुत अच्छा है, आपका पेपर छप भी जाए, एक्सेप्ट हो ही जाए। रिव्यूअर आदमी है, रिव्यूअर इज द ह्यूमन बीइंग इटसेल्फ। इट माइट बी पॉसिबल दैट इट इज बियॉन्ड द थिंकिंग और बियॉन्ड द अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर रिव्यूअर। इट हैपेंस विद मी दैट, एंड इट हैपेंस इवन द नोबेल लॉरेट्स गेट द रिजेक्शन, डजंट मीन दैट द पेपर इज नॉट ऑफ दैट क्वालिटी, सो डोंट बी डिसहार्टेंड। ओके, take the input as suggestions from rejections and submit to another journal. You know, I got 3 times revisions from a journal I won't name, and after the 3 revisions the journal rejected my manuscript. I wrote to the editor that please note my name and I will send you the same manuscript from the better journal than yours. Okay, I will get it published. And I sent the journal to send the same manuscript to another journal with better impact factor and get it published. So the reviewer may be wrong. So have faith, have confidence in you. Don't be overconfident, but at least have confidence in your work. Okay. दूसरी बात जो हम पूछ रहे थे कि क्या बात कर रहे थे? दूसरा क्वेश्चन आप रिपीट करेंगे? मैं भूल गया।
How to present negative results?
हाँ, negative results. देखिए, there are some journals which are exclusively publishing the negative results, and obviously even the negative results as well as I would like to add paradox. Hum pharmacy wale achhi tarah jante hain paradox kya hota hai. When the things are not going in the regular manner or abnormally koi cheez behave kare, say for example in general with the increase of temperature solubility increases. If the solubility is decreasing with the temperature increase, it means it's a paradox. So paradox as well as the negative reporting must be addressed in each and every article without any bias. ऐसा मैं अक्सर कहता हूँ कि research article लिखने का मतलब ये नहीं है, it is not like that कि जो तुमको हो पसंद वही बात करेंगे, मतलब जो जो अच्छा आया वही नहीं लिखना है। You should also write the negative thing, you should also write the limitations of your study in each and every article, and you can, and it should be a, it may be a part of the thing, but if the entire thing is gone wrong, then this is a problem. This may be a problem because it may be the question in your rationality ki aapne topic hi galat choose kiya. Ye bhi ho sakta. Lekin negative is, ha, if some portions are giving the negative results, if some aspects are negative, then okay, without any bias, without and being honest, you should present that yes, this is done wrong, or this is the negative result we have got. And because you never know, it is also the contribution to the knowledge domain, because some other person may take up that thing and convert it into the newer research. So don't be afraid of reporting the negative results and paradoxical results. Okay. Yes.
Yes, has disconnected. I will ask the next question. The question is from Pavan Kumar Singh. The question is, minimum number of paper to be referred to write a good review article.
Minimum number of
it depends on
the journal's requirement. हो सकता है कि आप किस जर्नल के लिए लिख रहे हैं, whether you are writing for a short review or whether you are writing for a अगर आप जर्नल के लिए जो है short review लिख रहे हैं, तो हो सकता है वो जर्नल्स का जो ट्रेंड है, it might be possible that it is accepting only 40 to 50 reviews, 50 references. But in journals like you go for the advanced degree reviews, you might have seen 250 references, 200, 300 references. It depends on the requirement and the trend of the journal. So you just see the journals रिक्वायरमेंट। मीनवाइल मैं एक चैट बॉक्स में आपके डाल रहा हूँ, कल हम एक टीम है हमारी, एक जो फार्मास्टेट एकेडमी के साथ हमारे एक रिसर्च आर्टिकल राइटिंग पे वी आर, आई एम गोइंग टू एड्रेस टुमारो, तो आई एम जस्ट सेंडिंग यू द लिंक इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड। आवर दिस इज अ पेड इवेंट बाय द फार्मास्टेट एकेडमी, सो इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड वी आर हैविंग ए 3 आवर सेशन ऑन रिसर्च आर्टिकल राइटिंग, यू आर वेलकम। फार्मास्टेट एकेडमी पे जाइए और देखिएगा, जुड़िए हमारे साथ अगले कल जो है हम लाइव होने जा रहे हैं। एनीवे, any next question please?
Okay, sir. Next question is from Dr. Trupti Pawar. The question is, how to find the journal which is perfect for your research topic, which will have a high acceptance of your manuscript or any website for the same available.
Okay, मैंने कहा ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि आपको कोई बता देगा कि जीनी आएगा कि नहीं इसमें पेपर पब्लिश कर दे आज इस वाले आर्टिकल के लिए. Then no genie is going to come. You are the genie of yourself. Okay. And for and it is not the generalized approach is not there, sir. I hope that आजकल हमारी जो now the students needs instant decisions or they need the instant solution. Like instant coffee, instant Maggie, instant noodle. Research is not noodle. Research is not instant noodle. You won't have the single solution for each and every cause. You will have to work. आपको हर एक पेपर के लिए हर एक स्ट्रैटेजी बनानी पड़ेगी. हर एक पेपर के लिए अलग टारगेट करना पड़ सकता है. और मैं की आपको बता रहा हूँ. Especially for the pharmaceutical researcher, just publish. Try to publish your paper in multidisciplinary journals. आप देखिए. I'm not having very much resources to be capable. I मैंने आज तक expert वो interested of pharmaceutical मेरा कोई paper नहीं. Phytotherapy okay I have published. Okay, I have published in Bentham Science, Springer, so many journals. I have published in the journals interdisciplinary. आप interdisciplinary जाएंगे तो you will have a good reach. अगर आपने कुछ काम chemistry oriented किया है तो don't be afraid of going towards the chemistry journals. So it would give a good lead as compared to focusing on your pharmacy journals only, because the pharmacy journals you will have to justify the things in many much more. They are expecting animal studies always. I am not having animal house since 18 years in my department. So what can I do? So I can't help in that way. So it doesn't mean that I can't publish the work. So you can go for publishing the work in those journals which don't require the animal studies. So sir, those journals, this is the art. You will have to publish for publishing and selecting. Okay.
Madam.
Yes. Thank you, sir. I think sir had. Yes. Yes. Yes, sir.
You can continue now.
Yes, Duma, sir. Okay, I think sir has solved our queries in very easy way. But as far as time is passing, I request Professor Sneha Patil madam to please conclude the session.
Thank you, Bhagyashima. Good afternoon to the honorable dignitaries, distinguished speaker, and your participants. I, Sneha Patil, on behalf of Rajmata Jizau Shikshan Prasarak Mandals College of Pharmacy, Institute of Pharmacy and its entire fraternity, feels immense pleasure to propose the vote of thanks of today's webinar. I extend my sincere gratitude to today's eminent speaker, Dr. Ajay Simalti sir, who has spared his precious time to guide and motivate us for the publication of articles in reputed journals. He rightly talked about journal targeting, do's and don'ts for publications. He enlightened us with the bibliometrics, tips to target high impact or quality journals. He also describes strategies of publication for every level of researchers. Sir also emphasizes on English in academic writing, plagiarism, advanced planning for the publication work or the research proposals or the research work, indexing agencies. He has also elaborated in details choice of the journals is depend on the impact, speed and research. And this is the very much important key factor in the publication aspect. Sir also gives the very much important information regarding the Swayam Prabha channel. And this is the very much useful for our final year students, that is for the NDDS subject and the cosmetics. Really thankful, sir. You are enlightened our session with your knowledgeful session. Thank you once again. I extend my grateful thanks to our president, Sri Vilas Rao Ji Lande sir, and the whole management team for allowing us to conduct webinar. I would specially thanks to our principal, Professor Dr. R. G. Kate Deshmukh, Vice Principal Amol Kumbar sir, and Dr. R. B. Chintamani, Principal of Institute of Pharmacy, for unfaltering support, motivation, and encouragement in us. My deep sense of appreciation and the thanks to all participants who choose to be live with us and attended the webinar with a great enthusiasm and made it a successful event. Behind every successful event lie the manifold attempts to our committed faculty. I would like to take a moment to acknowledge the immense contributions of our dedicated faculty team. Those are working for the previously 7 to 8 days. It's a really hard work they have to make this event successful one. Last but surely not least, I am really thankful to the backbone of today's session, that is the technical support provided by Mr. P.V. Rane sir, Mr. P.A. Pawar sir, and whole team. Because of their support, we can make this live through the YouTube channel also. So I will request all Zoom participants, please put on your video for photo session. Please, all participants, please put on your video for photo session. All participants, please fill the feedback form link, and the link for the feedback form is active till 10 p.m. today. You will receive e-certificate as per valid registration numbers within a week. And this webinar is available on RJSPM Pharmacy YouTube channel for the future use. Thank you all. Hoping the same response from your side for a future webinar. Have a great day ahead. Thanks to the all of participants, and especially once again the thanks to our eminent speaker Ajay Simaltis.
Thank you Sneha, thank you the organizing committee and the entire team. Thanks a lot. See you.
So here I conclude the session. Not for the session, but for the test.